What if I... Whoa, that's weird. So, like, check out the relative size of my cursor right now. It's a little taller than the eye. I maximized to full screen. It's itty bitty tiny, just a little smaller than the eye. So that's nice. I can actually open the window up to full screen and it'll still display properly for all of you. Oh, except that bottom there. That would be too distracting. All right. So a while back, like they've been adding content to this game so much. There's always, every week there's something new pretty much. They do like weekly patches. One of the things they added a long time ago were weekly and daily challenges. And I've been on and off practicing dailies, and just I think I have enough experience in this game to make them interesting to watch. Considering, obviously depending on what stat rolls we get, I might be able to survive a while, even with an odd combination of stats and mutations. So what is our daily today? Decent stats. Electrical generation, paralyzing. Oh, hey. Electromagnetic impulse. That's. I've never played with that before. Mental mirror and precognition. But those are gonna be low level because of my low ego stat. So this is definitely more of a melee focused character. Strength, agility, toughness, intelligence, willpower, all of those are in pretty good spots. So I think we might have some success with this. Oh, right. Most important, our character name will be Jake, pronounced like bacon. Howdy, Toothwave! Oh, Guild Wars 2. I played that for a little bit. It seems like a lot of fun. But I just wasn't in the mood for an MMO at the time. If I ever do get in the mood, though, that's the one I'll pick up. If I'm not playing CUD all the time. Moon and Sun, Wisdom and Will. Watervine Farmer's Prayer. Okay, so on the 28th of Tishru I Ux, we arrive at the oasis hamlet of Joppa. And I'm not going to read all the text. Like, I've played this game probably a maybe even 1,000 times at this point. So I'm going to be skipping a lot of it. I'll definitely read out generated things like Sultan life events and things like that. But if we're just talking to NPCs, I'm going to skip through the dialogue pretty quick. This is Mehmet. He's like the, I guess you could say, the supervisor, watervine farmer. But there's a better word for it. Better word for supervisor. Foreman. Yeah, he's the foreman. So you can tell me about Jampa, but I'm really just in search of work. So there are pale white spiderlings stealing all the water vine. So we gotta go find out what's up with that. Hey, Kermit Purple, it's your boy Jakin. Yep, it's me. Oh, I've got scaled leather boots. That's pretty good for a start. Let's look at Mehmet here. Fears of the desert have taken their toll on his body, but he commands your ear with his voice, like few other men. And you wonder what sovereignty might have come to were he not born a moisture farmer. He's loved by Joppa, hated by birds, antelopes, and cats. Not particularly worrisome. Here's a zealot of the 6 Day Stilt. I'm just gonna get his quest for a little XP boost if we ever end up over. Way over at the stilt, which is pretty far away. Howdy, Amaru. Yeah, I've streamed this game once or twice, but not a whole lot. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, let's I can do a little trick here, but I wanna think about this first. So all the faction reputation, except for like their base, is pretty much dynamic. So the elder here is hated by the Fellowship of Wardens, and outside, Warden Walrag, he is of the Fellowship of Wardens, so they won't have a good time if they meet up. What else? He's admired by the Pudis Templar, really? For making them feel welcomed at a supper feast. Okay, so he's gonna die once they get in combat, because I'm gonna make him fight. So I'm going to get as much reputation as I can before that happens. I'm pretty sure the Warden's gonna die. Oh, don't forget that Tessiphus here. Our little phosphorescent ray cat. Who has made a home for himself in the village of Joppa. If we pet Tessiphus, we start to glow. So that's nice. Yeah, let's get this fight started here. They just need to see each other, basically. Unless they don't want to fight. That's always a possibility. Oh, there we go. So let's observe what happens. Oh, the Warden got confused. It's gonna give the Elder an advantage. Tessiphus is getting in on this, too. Oh, here comes Mehmet. It's an all-out brawl now. Oh, the Warden's gonna be perma-confused. Poor guy. That's the thing, like, sometimes Espers can just do that to you, and then what are you gonna do? Die. We're just watching Warden slowly get killed here. Beautiful. Now I get to take all of his stuff. Glow Sphere. Yeah, that's gonna go in my left hand. Can you have an army of cats? You could have up to 2 cats at once. I don't know if that constitutes an army. Alright, so Warden's dead, everyone's covered in blood, and I should have got a freeze ray. I got this longsword. A vibro blade. Now, that's pretty good to start. It does 1d10 damage. But it only has 4 penetration unless I put an energy cell in it, which I don't have right now. I thought he had, Oh no, the Warden must have freezing hands. I thought he had an artifact for that. What? Okay, there's a lot of weird infighting going on here. Mehmet is now dead. Means I don't think I can get my quest reward for the Pale Spiderling quest. That's kind of bad. But what can you do? I'm just gonna steal everything in these chests. Usually a good way to start the game. Skulk Injector, this is something I don't use very often. Poison Gas Grenade, also something I don't use very often. Freeze Grenade, that's a little better. But I'm probably going to trade those for the quest anyway. It is kind of an old-fashioned game with a modern GUI. It used to be, like, ASCII only. Everything was text, but now they've added tiles, and tiles are fucking amazing. So this is Argive. He's the resident tinker of the town. He doesn't care about us, except if we can get him some knickknacks. You can have my poison gas grenade, and he wants another one. You can have the freeze grenade. And I got a quest to find some copper wire. Alright, I'm gonna try this out. I have the Vibro Blade equipped. It should still do 4 penetration and 1d10 damage. It should be okay for the early game. Hello, Narappa. It's nice to see you. What you may not know is there's actually a little crack in the ground there. leads us to an underground cave, which we'll be checking out right away, as soon as we look at this statue of Antizerdates the Fifth. Okay, depicts a significant life from Antizerdates' life. A significant event. Look, I haven't done a stream in a while, I forgot how to talk. In 447, a corrupt administrator was appointed minister of the market aristocracy of Tervakesh. He outlawed the practice of glass blowing, and I'm never gonna pronounce that right. And the Sultan was forced to flee. So we learned about a historic location. We got a quest to visit that location. That should appear right here on our map. We might make it there, we might not. I'm feeling pretty okay about surviving on this character, but you never know what's gonna happen. Living mice. Okay, so we go down here. There's a few enemies. I'm gonna go back up and let them come to me. Hello, friend. I can still kind of cheese enemies on stairs, which is very useful. That one was standing under the stairs, so he was an easy kill. And in the early game, one reason I like to come down here is because you don't start out with all your equipment slots filled. So right now I have a pocketed vest that gives me no DV. Sorry, gives me one DV, which is the gray circle, and zero AV, which is the blue diamond. AV is... like, both are important for your defense, but you need to have kind of a baseline armor value, AV, in order to not get just clowned on by everything. So that's usually my first priority in a game, is getting that started. Having boots and a hat is really good. That's 2 AV right there. I can put in chainmail. I'm up to 5 now. With gloves, I could get up to 6. And that's usually enough to carry you to at least 2 Golgotha, if not past it. Are we talking about, like, computer mice or animal mice, or some weird fusion of the two? I also like this area because it's usually pretty easy. There aren't a whole bunch of tough enemies to deal with, and you can often get an easy level up and some equipment down here without too much risk. You can also get some items to sell. If we're really lucky, there will be a chem cell or a higher tier weapon at the vendor. Take bronze longsword, bronze dagger. Weapons are usually a good pick for selling. Not as good as trade goods, obviously, but better than most armor. Until you get into the late game armor, that stuff will sell for more water than you can possibly carry. Oh yeah, so if you don't know of this game, it takes place in the far, far future, post-apocalypse, to the point where memories of the old world are few and far between, if they exist at all. You know what? I'm going to trade my leather armor for that chainmail. Because 1 AV isn't going to make that huge of a difference. And it gives me an extra DV. Like I said, it's definitely a balancing act with your defenses. So yeah, we're at the point in history now where... well, I shouldn't say too much. Things are happening. And there's work being done. What just happened? Oh, I surged with energy. Oh, that's my electromagnetic pulse. See, now my vibroblade is EMP'd. It's not going to... I don't know why regular weapons get EMP'd. Except bronze daggers, apparently. Or is it only the first one in a stack? Anyway, that means I can't use the obviously electronic functions of it, but it should still function as a weapon. Alright. Hello, Gingeretta. I have not played Dungeons of Dreadmoor. I own it. I think I booted it up once, but I don't know. I really like Caves of Cut. Oh no, the torches have been EMP'd. I really hope, like, hitting a friendly with that won't aggro them. Because that could lead to my untimely death. Alright, let's talk to Tam here, the Dromad Merchant. He's a Dromad, a Salt Strider. So let's do some trading. Boomerose arrows are always good to have some of. Lead slugs. What do we got? Those are boxes of crayons, I'm pretty sure. So if you haven't encountered an artifact before, you'll need to identify it. And unfortunately, Tam can't identify artifacts, so we'd have to buy these without knowing exactly what they are. Does bronze hold a charge? Well, it is copper and tin, so it might hold a charge. Howdy, Zarly. Counterweighted 2 carbide dagger. I actually have enough water to buy that straight up. That would be better. Probably better than the vibro blade. It would scale with my strength a lot better, even though it does 4 less potential damage. And considering my low ego, that's the best I'm gonna get. Sell the rest of this. Try to make it up to at least 60 water. Oh right, I'm an Arcanaut, so I have the start of the tinkering skill tree, which is one of the best skill trees in the game. Possibly, probably, potentially. Oh, perfect, I ended up with 59 water. So I can equip this in my main hand. I'm gonna hold on to that. Oh, I already have a short bow. Zap! Another EMP pulse. Okay, well, it does not aggro friendlies. That's good to know. Yeah, the music in this game, it was another thing that was added. I guess it was added this year. But it's really good. It's just good. It's really good. So I'm going to set Discharge to 1. Sting. I don't really use that as an active ability, because what it'll do, I have a stinger on my back right now, with paralyzing venom. It will attack randomly during melee, but I can also sting with it to get an increased chance to hit and penetrate, and obviously apply my venom. But I think while that's on cooldown, you won't randomly attack with it. And I found those random attacks are more useful than the occasional forced attack. Precognition is interesting too. Period and comma, those two. So that's, it's almost like a quick save, and then you have a limited time to play after that. And when your time runs out, you can either choose to revert to when you quick saved, or continue on with that timeline. It's basically like precognition. It's says it right there. You know what's funny, Gingeretta? You can find hookahs out in the world. Oh no, I'm eating my canned mystery meat. Don't do that. Don't do that. Canned mystery meat is super great because it heals you as a food item, so I want to be eating everything but that. Like star apples. Oh hey, let's check out the graveyard. This is another kind of procedurally generated thing. In loving memory of Uqua, died of mathematical causes. Ooh, that's a rough way to go. Here lies the body of Yayu Shrosham. crushed to death by a falling irritable tortoise corpse. Here rests Thai shrimp, choked on raw barkbiter meat. I bit him back, I guess. Here rests the body of Yish Rawr, chopped into small pieces by roots. Ooh. Rest in peace, Ktep, died of ceremonial causes. Here rests Ocean, became obsessed with a sheaf of tattered parchment and forgot to eat. Oh, I know what that's like. I know what that's like. Alright. Another little strategy I'm doing here. So, we have our world map, and each tile on the world map is 9x9... Not 9x9. 3x3, or 9 squares of screen. So I just walked out of the Joppa tile into this tile, so I only have to make one world map move to get to Red Rock, as opposed to two. It saves a little bit of time, saves a little bit of your food and water resources. So that's just something I will do occasionally. Especially when I'm trying to conserve my canned mystery meat. I don't have harvest, do I? No. I say that because a witchwood tree gives witchwood bark, which is one of the best healing items in the game, if only for its abundance and ease of use. For the most part, it has a chance to confuse you, but being confused at high health is generally better than, you know, knowing what you're doing at no health. It also heals you instantly, so that's a big, big bonus. Alright. Mental mutations, there's no point in leveling those up because my ego's so low. I would be getting a -2. Yeah, levels reduced by 2, but it can only go down to 1, so they at least have their level 1 effects. Electrical generation, yeah, I'll boost that up. I'll also boost my stinger. If I'm using daggers, I want more agility anyway. I might put into strength later, but right now. Oh, I do start out with spry. That's really good. Swift reflexes and spry. If you are putting any investment into dodge at all, you want those. Because you get a straight up +2 bonus and +5 bonus when flinching away from projectiles. Okay, I'll get bloodletter for short blades. I'll stab things and they'll bleed. Disassemble is also on my short list. But that'll take a few more levels up. Alright. Let's go downstairs. Wow, what an unlucky start. I came down the stairs. There's a jilted lover right beside me. They're stationary roots that cling to walls, but they'll fuck you up. And it's grabbed me currently. I'm also... Okay, either I'm grabbed by that, or I'm stuck in this slimy asphalt here. I'm surrounded by snapjaws, one of which has a bow. This is already kind of... I should have done precognition before I stepped downstairs. What can I do? Alright, I'm gonna discharge into the jilted lover. That'll kill it. And I'll let these snapjaws come to me. Or just heal to full. Oh, they're attacking me through the floor. There we go. Grab these tar-encrusted bones. There are a lot of 5-pound corpses that are really good for being, like, in between food. So right now I'm using it to buffer out my canned mystery meat. Because you will consume your corpses before you consume your foodstuffs. Warren Bernoose. That'd be good if I didn't have a stinger. Oh, and these guys here, they're Dreadroot. If you stand near them, they might occasionally terrify you, cause you to run away. Okay, after the little incident of entering this floor, I think I'm gonna be pretty safe. As long as I don't do anything stupid, like almost get killed by that jilted lover. Oh, boarskin gloves. That is my final basic piece of AV equipment. But I can't equip it right now. By the way, this UI, this is also, it's kind of pre-release content at this point. This is your usual inventory. But, they've got it to the point where it's working really well, so I like this. And because you can use your mouse. Oh yeah, glow sphere, it's my light source. Otherwise I'd have a torch in that hand. You can get light sources you don't need to hold in hand, but that's not gonna happen immediately. There's a mossy tube. Salve injector. That is one of the healing injectors that we can get. Very good to have around. That young ivory nearly killed me. Thanks for making me bleed, buddy. Isn't all meat corpses? You know, maybe. But not all corpses are meat. Yeah, I'd say it's safe to say that meat is corpses. Ooh, a painted bronze dagger. Let's have a look here. We're gonna learn something about a sultan. Oh, this is our anti... Oh, and the fourth. So this would be the parent of the sultan we read about before. So in 314, Anti-Serdates rampage through all of Mikesh, looting all of the jewels from the homes of newly sentient beings and insects. He became known as the Terror of Mikesh. So we learned another historical site. I'll grab that. More tar-encrusted bones to eat. Hey, a freeze grenade. That could save my life. Aw, night, Narappa. Thanks for stopping by. Ugh. Slime everywhere. It's a little troublesome to get around in. Oh, that's right. Since I'm an Arcanaut, I rifle through garbage. That could be useful. Okay, some bad news here. So in zones that spawn with asphalt pools, you occasionally get Kindle-thumbed enemies, which means they have the Flaming Hands mutation, so they can shoot flames. And asphalt is highly flammable. So I'm gonna back off. Asphalt's gonna be burning down there when I come down. Alright, let's play with precognition a little bit. So I am now in the middle of a vision. How long does it last? So I have 16 rounds to go down there and take a run at it. One thing that I didn't realize, if you die during your precognition, you're dead. So don't assume you can just flail around safely and not get killed, because you will get killed. Okay, that went better than I could have expected. I will not return to the start of my vision. I got set on fire. If you're set on fire, probably the best thing to do is try and put the fire out, unless you're in danger of catching more fire by standing still. Because passing a turn will make you beat at the flames and try and stop being on fire, pretty much. More tar bones. Hey, he wasted his flame on something else. A bat. Bat corpses are also good as snacks. Sturdy leather cap? Well, it's better than what I have. Stop, drop, and roll right in the asphalt. Well, that's funny. He lit the fire pit on fire, but it didn't catch fire. Yeah, there's a lot of heat-based damage in this area. Okay. Let's see what we got here. Discharge. Always a good choice. A painted masterwork bronze two-handed sword. Anti-Zerdates 3. At dawn, under an uncanny and scarlet sky, the people of the gambling den of the Frosty saw an image on the horizon that looked like a snowflake bathed in scarlet. It was Anti-Zerdates 3. And after she came and left the gambling den of the Frosty, the people built a monument to her, and thenceforth called her the Scarlet Snowflake. A little bit of Sultan history there. We're learning about the entire lineage of this Sultan family, which is pretty cool. Yeah, because of my higher tier weapon, like carbide you wouldn't start finding until about ruins, I can just clown all of these snapjaws without much concern. Okay, more fire. Oh, there's lots of fire. It's getting hot in here. Hey, you think you're the only one who can fire a bow? Okay, that's stun gas, which is fine. Stun gas isn't particularly dangerous. Is that a kindle-thumbed cannibal? Okay. Yeah, this is what I was worried about. I'm on fire. Can I eat a mystery meat? There we go. Health is maxed. So I like leather aprons more than leather armor, because they give the same armor, but weigh a lot less. Pocketed vest sells good. Aw, you're welcome, Onion. Also nice to see you, buddy. Sloppy Sultan History Mystery Cave. Very good. Everything is Kindle thumbed in here. Would you stop lighting me on fire? Even if just for a moment? Oh no, the Beetleblum's on fire. Beetleblums are cool. An orbicular beetle that roams and ingests, which is like the best description you can get of that thing. It'll walk around and eat everything. So, there are certain areas with static item spawns, and if you absolutely can't find the item spawn, that usually means a Beetleblum ate it. So you'll either have to kill them or befriend them. Or, you know, just go without the item, but that's not something I tend to do. How am I doing on corpses? I've got 35 pounds, that's 7 corpses. If I grab this one, I'll pretty much be set for most of Red Rock. Hey, Zarf, good morning. How are you doing today? Sunday fun day? Okay. So, wow. I mean, it's a testament to this build that I'm still alive, because I haven't been playing that smart. And, like, these areas are extremely dangerous. You might have caught that. I just had my stinger go off there. Everything's on fire, but I will take that sap mask. It's basically like a low quality gas mask. Hey, it's like how days work. The day doesn't change until you go to sleep. And it's not morning until you wake up. It's just how the world works. I wonder if this will work. If I light the campfire, is it going to ignite the asphalt? No. Okay, so campfire doesn't spread across tiles like flaming items will.
Oh, hey Shima! Hey Val! How are you two doing today?
I hope it's good. Because I don't know how to respond to people who are unhappy. No. I'm acting weird today. Don't mind me. Don't mind me, I'm just saying weird shit for no real reason. Beetlebum, why? Why are you coming this way when you are attacked? You must fight, Beetlebum. Fight, or you will die. It's really not concerned with fighting that seed-spitting plant. There we go. Maybe because there's nothing to eat over here. Ah, not the tonsils. I'm lucky that the worst I get is tonsil stones on occasion. Oh! Okay, so there's a Gershling nearby. We got the reward for spotting it. I'm gonna let it come to me. Yeah, there we go. Black ooze drips from its fangs to its pallid leg things. It shudders in primordial ecstasy and lets out a shrill whine that pierces your skull. That's the Gershling. Let's see if we can kill it. It's helpful if it remains stuck. Okay, this thing's stronger than me. So I'm just gonna zap it. There we go. No problem. Now grab the corpse and get out of here. You can, obviously, like, continue exploring down here. Let's see. If you follow the river, it'll go all the way down, and at the end of the river, if you take the staircases up, you will actually end up back at Joppa. So this tunnel connects to the crack in the ground in Joppa. And the way I do my start, or, like, early game stuff is I will come down this side of Red Rock, grab the corpse, go back to Joppa, get my rewards, which I might not be able to get because Mehmet is dead, and then go down the other side of the tunnel till I find the static item spawn I want, grab that, and continue on with quests. You can do it any way you like, this is just my method that I've found. Oh, that's right. You live right in the path of the forest fire smoke. Ugh. Oh, I was trying to travel to Joppa and I got lost. That shouldn't be too bad. If I keep traveling south, I'll eventually... Yeah, there we go. Well, at this point, maybe I'll just walk. See, Mehmet is dead. Can I talk to the Elder? Oh, I can! So, we have a discussion with the Elder about the Gershlings and things that are going on. And I did get my rewards. Awesome. Especially because you get 3 salve injectors and an Uber Nostrum injector. And this Fix-It spray foam. All super useful items. Uber Nostrum, especially because it is part of the cure for glot rot, which, if we make it that far, we're likely to catch. It'll also grow back any appendages you have cut off. At least one. Prickly boons? Best boons? So now we have our wire quest. Tam hasn't restocked yet. Oh, that's right. Gotta go down. Balloons. Baboon balloons? Babloons? Grandfaloon? Driftloon. Good. Oh, I have mutation points to spend. Electrical generation and stinger. So electrical generation, you gain charges every X rounds up to a maximum, and once you get it to level 10, it's actually powerful enough if you're fully charged to almost one-shot a Slumberling, which if we encounter a Slumberling, I'll be sure to point it out. They are extremely difficult enemies, but with a little twist that keeps them from being always a one-shot kill until you hit like level 18. Oh, I'm sorry, Toothwave. Thanks for hanging out while you could, and good luck today. Maybe people won't shop much because it's Sunday. Right, so one thing you can do if you don't like the combat log getting in the way here, you can zoom in and, like zoom way in. That's my character, by the way. I'm an Arcanaut. But I like to play zoomed out because I like to see the whole map at once. Big pixels, yes. Oh, I don't like this. I don't like seed spitting plants, because delicate viridian tendrils curl inward and then spring open and loosen seeds at high speeds. They're like turrets, and they will chew you up until you get 6 DV or more, pretty much. Even then, they can still be dangerous. So having 2 in an open area like this, something I want to avoid. Stop hitting me through the floor. Ooh, jewel-encrusted leather boots. I'll take those. Jewel-encrusted increases the value of an item, and if you're wearing it, it gives you reputation with water barons. But right now I have scaled boots, And reputation with unshelled reptiles is kind of important to staying alive throughout a lot of this game. If you can stay friendly with unshelled reptiles, you'll have a much easier time of it. Good. I left the area and the snapjaws and seed-spitting vines kind of took care of each other there. And maybe I'll just go down again instead of exploring this, because the staircase is right there. I don't need to be seed spit at. What the heck? Sorry, just a moment. All better. Why don't you come over to me, Hunter? There we go. Ooh, a bloodstained neck ring. It's a trade item, but it also gives you lots of reputation with baboons. Yeah, 400 per. So if I equip two of these, I don't have to worry about getting pelted with rocks in case we run into any. What's this? A love injector. This is one that's been added in the past month or so. So when you, or when any creature is injected with it, they feel unusually amorous for about half a day, during which time you'll fall in love with the first thing you look at. Oh, if you inject someone else, they'll fall in love with you and follow you around for 3,000 to 3,600 rounds. And a 4% failure rate for every level higher they are than you. Now, I can't equip this in my main hand, so once we spot a decent enemy, I'm going to try making it fall in love with me. That's a mechanic I haven't played with yet. Oh, do I still have... Yeah, I'm still carrying all these torches and I don't need to. Yeah, that's kind of the case, Onion. It is easy to cheese a lot of the ranged enemies by just hiding out of sight. Except for turrets, because they don't move, and they don't run out of ammo. Like the seed-spitting vine here. Those things are fucking dangerous. A jewel-encrusted beaded bracelet. Now that's going to be worth a lot of money. Also, do beaded bracelets give you any rep? No, not basic ones. Never underestimate the power of Orb. Orb will show you the way. Chris LT, how's it going? Ooh, engraved leather cap. Antizer dates 1. The first in the lineage. Deep in the wilds of the consulate autarchy of Tarkanip, Antizerdates stumbled onto a clan of water barons performing a secret ritual. Because of her lustrous visage, they furiously rebuked her and declared her a villain to their kind. Man, Sultan history is always interesting. They're always getting up to some wacky antics. Here we go. Here's the end of the river I mentioned earlier. So, we follow this. It should be 3 more screens, and then we're at the spawn area for the items I want. Ooh, garbage. I take. Skill points. What do I got for skill points? Yeah, I'm gonna grab disassemble. Now we can start pulling apart scrap and artifacts for bits, which take up no inventory space and can be used to craft. So, I don't really need an EMP grenade, I'll disassemble that. When tinkering, always have a basic toolkit in your inventory, because it increases the likelihood of recovering additional bits. So how disassembly works is, say you have the vibro blade here. It's made up of a D, an A, a 1, and a 5. I have the colorblind settings on, so otherwise these would just be like squares with colors, and I think this is just better for readability overall. Anyway, we would be guaranteed to get a 5-bit from disassembling, with 50% chance to get each lower tier bit. With a toolbox, I don't know what increases the chance to, but it does increase that chance. So, if you're disassembling scrap with 1 bit, it doesn't matter. Anything else, you really do want to have the toolkit. Now, I have it set to auto-disassemble, so if I pick these up, it saves me having to hit M on each one. Yeah, what Val said, like, post-apocalypse roguelike, with all kinds of weird technology, like injectors that make you fall in love with things. Still haven't found a good candidate to fall in love with, though, or to have fall in love with me. I should just be following the river. Oh, you know what? If I find a Beetlebum, that's who I'm gonna befriend. Beetlebum make great companions. Also, I just like the name Beetlebum. 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 It's good. Beetlebum. Beetlebum lover. Hey, Kermit Purple. I'm not sure if I said hi to you earlier. I figured I'd say it now. It's one screen, two screen. The next screen up should be our treasure trove. Oh, friendly fire there. I won't complain. Ooh, a compound bow. That's not a common find. It's better than a short bow because it's a little more accurate, but aside from that, it's pretty much identical. So I grab it just because, like, why not? Alright, so cracked is... wait. This item cannot break. Cracked is an effect that can happen to your items from enemy attacks, where it reduces the AV value you get from them. This UI is... it seems to be missing important things. I'm gonna have to deal with that once I'm done fighting. So I thought the sturdy modifier on my leather cap would prevent it from being cracked, but I guess not? It says this item cannot break, but I've never had items break before. Only rust, crack... cracking is temporary, by the way, so it'll revert. Rusting, cracking... you can break items when you attempt to identify them. That's the only thing I can think of. Yeah, I did unload the bow in my inventory for that sweet, sweet one wooden arrow onion. Ah, yes. Go enjoy your soups, Val. I hope they have noodles in them. That's my kind of soup. Okay, so I'm just gonna discharge on this null worm. Fuck it. Light some fires. Okay, can I... no, you don't... you can't adjust your... oh, here we go. I was looking at it wrong. So here you can see all my stats. My AV value, DV value. MA. I forget what MA is. It's not temperature. Temperature's over here. It's important for catching on fire or freezing. I forget what MA is. Let's see. Oh, mental armor. How well protected you are against mental attacks. Most characters start with a base MA of 4. So, yeah, I have a little more mental armor than everyone else, but not really a lot. Another point in electrical generation. I can get tinkering level 1. What schematic do we want? Excuse me. I'm gonna take desert rifle. Drop a recoiler, we'll get one for free pretty soon. An HE missile I don't use a lot. We also got the ability to recharge cells, so we basically have unlimited, pretty much unlimited energy at this point, if we ever find a chem cell. My Massachusetts value. So I'll learn the desert rifle. I don't think I can build it yet. No, I need a flawless crystal. As soon as we find one, though, I'm gonna have a pretty decent ranged weapon. Acid gas grenade. I'll disassemble that. Okay, now I'm looking for a pre-spawned corpse in this area. Oh, there's a chameleon. Good. Good, we are friendly with unshelled reptiles. Because chameleons have the ability to make you bleed, and especially early game, bleeding can just outright kill you. So it pleases me that we are friends. Which means it'll make my enemies bleed. You know what? I'm gonna rest up. Where'd that chameleon go? Let's hit it with a love injector. You miss. You hit. Yeah, you hit for 2 damage with your love injector. Horned chameleon falls in love with Jaken. Well, that's weird. It shows it as, applying it to itself, which isn't quite accurate, but that's probably just how they had to set it up. So yeah, now I've got a horned chameleon friend who is madly in love with me. Aww, lovesick. So, 3600 turns, eh? I wonder if it's gonna go hostile to me at the end of that. Either way, it's good to have a friend. Buy butchery here real quick. It's a good thing to have in general. Somebody's starting a lot of fires. Back off a little bit and I'm gonna use my freeze grenade. These eyeless crabs are a little dangerous. Have a very high AV value. There we go. High AV, and they can crack your armor with their claws, which also have a high penetration value. Yay, unrequited love! Aw, it's just like high school. I like all the color changes this chameleon's going through. I believe it does change color to match whatever background tile it was on last. So that's super neat. It was, here we go, I found what I wanted. The corpse. So it parts, ancient bones, miner's helmet, pickaxe, tattered parchment, which is just a little journal written by what I assume to be a dwarf. Looking for Jasper. Couldn't find his Jasper. Crab eggs? Bizarre scuttling noise. No, Jasper! I know your pain, buddy. We all want Jasper to return. Jasper Redemption is real. That ability is not enabled? Disabled. Wait. Did I? Am I EMP'd? I am EMP'd. I didn't think EMP would disable my mutations. That's a little weird. Oh, later, Amaru. Please do wash, Chameleon. So, I don't know if that's supposed to happen, but it definitely did happen. Maybe I should report that as a bug. Okay, so we've got pretty much everything I want down here in these tunnels. It's time to head back to town. My chameleon just wants to keep murdering, though, which I'm okay with. Oh boy. It's getting busy down here. Oh no, our chameleon died. Aw. Now their love can never be requited properly. We'll never forget Chameleon Buddy, who I didn't even name. Cammy Leon, that'll be his name. Oh, ooh, there's a Slumberling nearby. I'm not gonna hunt it down, though. I don't feel like dying. Especially because, yeah, we're doing pretty good so far. Joppa, and the merchants have restocked. See, Argive will have some schematics, none of which I'm too terribly in need of. Unfortunately, our chameleon friend did not leave a corpse. More lead slugs, always good. This artifact is a grenade, so I don't want it. Some more carbide stuff. Oh, let's look at this engraved steel cookery. Antizerdates 5. At the Battle of Urkupad Tangle, Antizerdates 5 fought as a mercenary to liberate Roots. She wielded a prismatic dagger with such finesse that it became forever known as Prismaticus. Prismaticus, the friend of Roots. So, I guess we now have knowledge of this artifact that exists, but we don't know where it is. Because there will be information out there that will tell us where to find said dagger. It's just a question of will we find it before we die? There's something else I wanted to do in town. Oh, yes. I want to talk to the elder. So, We're going to take a little reputation hit with the Fellowship of Wardens, but we will do the water ritual with Irudad. And share a secret about, oh, the history we just learned. So now I can buy Harvestry with that reputation I gained. And Harvestry means Witchwood Bark, which means better survivability.